In mythology, when a hero goes to the underworld, it's usually symbolic of searching inside one's own unconscious and always looking for that transcendent reality in life. So I suppose in that sense, the name is pretty appropriate.
Where I really felt at home. It's a city that's got, there's a history of communication. You know, astrologically it's ruled by Aquarius. It's a very modern city. It's to do with water, transport, media, music, magic. It's a very modern city. It's to do with water, transport, media, music, magic.
I was really interested in the whole Age of Enlightenment idea, the Rosicrucian and Masonic ideals that came up and were expressed in the French Revolution and then in the American Revolution.
Magic back then was very, very definitely a very strong revolutionary liberation force.
This idea of the secret history of Europe, of the concepts of liberty, equality, and fraternity that grew up through the various secret magical orders of the 16th, 17th, 18th centuries. I mean, this area here was a big center of alchemy and Rosicrucianism back in the 17th century.
That's the thing you have to do is, as a magician, is find some other practitioners. By that or whatever, I find people who were into Crowley, right, who were sort of successors of Crowley, what they call the OTO, the Order Templi Orientis, which is the order that Crowley took over and popularized as the main, in my opinion, main modern vehicle for hermetic magic. The ancient science of magic. And the main representatives of that at the time, so I thought, was the OTO.